something coalesces. And the something coalesces into neater and neater structures that look more and more like hexagonal patterns. So we're busy trying to understand now how this operates and also to demonstrate it experimentally. So new microscopic techniques, it's possible to see hair bundles actually broken. So this is from a fish. This is a newly formed hair cell. This is a newly formed hair cell. As yet, they don't have hair bundles, unlike these more mature cells in which you can see the cilia sticking out. But in the time lapse, over about 12 hours, watch these stereocilia grow. So here they come. They're getting taller and taller and taller. And we hope eventually to be able to follow them all the way to full maturity. So we're trying to test these ideas of chemical reactions that produce these mature hair bundles. The final thing I want to deal with. Regular hair bundles, with age, with chemicals, with sound damage, they become disheveled. And the bad news is that in mammals, when one of these cells is damaged, it always dies. It is not replaced by cell division. So it's like the cells in one's brain or one's heart. Once they're gone for good. And because each of these cells or groups of cells represents a particular frequency of sound, those particular frequencies are lost as well. So one place we've investigated this is the lateral line organ of the zebrafish larva. So zebrafish... along their side, they have something called the lateral line. These yellow organs, which have been stained with a dye, each of which is a cluster of hair cells. These hair cells reach out into the water, and they feel water motion. So they can feel water moving past the fish, they can feel the fish moving through the water. They can detect predators. They can detect prey. They're a very important sense for these fish. Each of these little clusters, which is called a neuromast, has hair cells, red and green in this case, red and blue, sorry, in this case, and they're of opposite polarity.